Oke, daripada sini, multiplexer and demultiplexer are used when data from several sources are to be transmitted over one line to a distant location. Okay, example using multiplexer to select data at the transmitter part to be transferred to the line and distribute to several destination using the multiplexer. Okay, ini sebagai contoh lah, switching sequence control input, switching sequence control input. So kita ada A, B, C, and then keluar satu. Okay, ini adalah max. Ini adalah D max. Max maksud masuk banyak. Okay, masuk 3, keluar 1. D max maksud masuk 1, keluarlah berapa. Okay, okay. A multiplexer max is device that allow digital information from server source to be routed in the signal. Ni yang atas tadi. The basic multiplexer has several data input line, a single output line. It also has data select input which permit data on my one of the input to be switching to the output line. Okay. Functional diagram of a MUX. Okay. Okay, ni saya cakap tadi. This is select input. Okay, this is a data input. So select input ni kita akan gunakan S lah, S kosong sehingga S N. Okay, okay, ini adalah input data. Okay, input. Okay, konsep dah sama aja macam tadi. Ini S, ini I, I N. Okay, input data. This is a output Z. Okay, okay. Functional diagram of MUX. A multiplexer has N control input, 2 N data input and 1 output Z. Okay, ini saya beritahu tadi lah di sini macam mana pengiraan dia. Okay, yang saya beritahu tadi ni. Okay, okay, macam mana pengiraan dia. Okay, semua bergantung kepada N. Okay, kalau N, N is equal to S tadilah, S not. Okay, okay, kalau N S not sehingga S N, senang. Okay, kalau in case N tu kita nak pakai macam tadi 4. Okay, 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So S not, S1, S2, S3. So N dia adalah bersamaan dengan 3. Eh sorry, N dia bersamaan dengan 4. Okay, bila N ni, ini N, N, N sama dengan 4. Untuk dapatkan input data, okay, untuk dapatkan ni is 2 kuasa 4. Maksud 2 kali 2 kali 2 kali 2. So 2 kali 2 4, 4 kali 2 8, 4 kali 2 16. So I N ni, okay, I ni input data kita adalah 16. Okay, input data kita adalah 16. Okay, simple lah, senang. Okay, input 16, keluar dia 1. Okay, keluar dia 1. Okay, macam mana dia nak select sekejap lagi? Sekejap lagi saya akan explain. Okay, okay, MUX function table and boolean expression. Okay, di sini kita tengok. Okay, N dia sama dengan 2. So data input is 2 kuasa 2. Okay, 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 sekali lagi, n is equal to 2. So I is equal to 2 power of n. Okay, ini adalah n. So 2 kuasa n dengan 2 kuasa 2 bermaksud I kita ada 4. So mean sini kita ada I kosong, I 1, I 2, I 3, I 4. So kita ada 4 input based on this. Okay, based on this. Okay, macam mana kita nak detect based on this truth table? Okay, based on this truth table. Okay, truth table this kosong kosong I not. Okay, kosong kosong I not. Kosong satu, kosong satu. Okay, kosong kosong I not. Kosong satu I satu. Satu kosong I dua. Satu satu I tiga. Okay, simple ya benda ni. Very simple. Okay, kita dah just tahu, kita tahu kosong kosong is equal to kosong. Kosong satu is equal to satu. Okay, satu kosong is equal to 2. Satu satu is equal to 3. Okay, so konsep dia kamu tengok di sini je lah. I kosong, I satu, I dua dan I tiga. So means sekiranya, okay, sekiranya A, B ni, A, B ni satu, satu. So dia akan pilih di sini. Satu, satu dia akan ambil I tiga yang akan keluar dekat Z. Okay, simple lah. Simple sangat. Okay, so Z, okay, Z equal, berbalik lah ni, A bar, B bar, A bar, B, A, B bar, A, B. Okay, this is a Z punya equation. Okay, okay, kita sambung. Okay, this is mark function table and boolean expression. Okay, this is mark function table and boolean expression. Okay, daripada sini, daripada sini kita akan come out, kita akan come out this. Okay, kita akan come out this equation. Okay, ini adalah equation daripada, sorry, daripada sini. Okay, Z A bar B I not. So kita sambung lah, kita buat lah kita punya expression. So macam banyak kali saya cakap, rule, okay, rules untuk digit ni, satu problem, okay, lepas dua problem, lepas dua problem kita akan dapat, okay, so problem sekarang adalah marks. Okay, daripada marks ni, okay, ini adalah problem ataupun masalah dia. Okay, daripada situ apa yang marks tu nak, kita akan come out kan truth table. Okay, truth table, truth, okay, table. Okay, nombor 3, from truth table kita akan keluarkan K-map. Okay, okay, ingat ni, okay, daripada truth table ni, Okay, daripada K-map, once K-map, kita akan dapat 4, kita akan dapat expression. Okay, boolean expression. Okay, nombor 5, baru kita akan dapat this. Kita akan dapat this. Okay, kita akan dapat what we call daripada bullet expression, kita convertkan kepada logic. Logic gates. Okay, ini logic gate. So 5 rule ni yang kamu kena, kamu kena ingat. So kalau kamu tahu benda ni, any design pun yang kamu nak kena buat, kamu akan faham. So semua sama je rule ni. Okay, rules digit untuk this semester. Okay, ada berapa problem? First problem, and then ada berapa problem, kita come up to table, and then kita buat K-map, kita buat K-map, buat bullet expression, and last sekali baru kita dapat logic gate. Okay, okay. Marks output waveform in a relation with the data input and data select waveform. Okay, okay, bila kamu tengok sini, okay, sekarang kita ada, this is a input. Okay, this is a selector. Ini adalah data kita tu. Okay, the binary state of the data selects input during each interval determine which data input is selected. Here the data select input go through a repetitive binary sequence 00 01 10 01 00. Okay, okay. Kalau kita tengok sini, kita dah tahu dah very simple punya terms. Okay, 00 01 10 01. Okay, kalau 00 is 00 01 10 02 11 3. Okay, so di sini kita tengok 00 adalah 0. So apa yang dia akan pilih, 00 dia akan pilih di note. 10 dia pilih di 1, 01 dia pilih di 2, 11 dia pilih di 3. Okey. And then 00 balik di 0, 10 di 1, di 2, 11 di 3. And then designing logic circuit using MUX. Implement logic function specific table number using 7-H AC151 A input data selector atau multiplexer. Compare this method with discrete logic gate implementation. Okay, notice from the two table, that's why is a 1 for the following input variable combination 001 001 101 101 and 10. For all the combination, y is 0 for the function to be implemented with the data selector. The data input select by each the above mentioned combination must be connected to high 5 volt. All the other data input must be connected to low ground. Okay, bila lapar input, okey, lapar input, first kita check 8 input and then dia beritahu 001111 and 110 is connected to 1. So means 001 011 101 and 110 11, all this Y is equal to 1 and the rest is equal to 0. Okay, yang ni lah yang rest dia. Okay, ni, ni, this and this. And then they mention here the data input selected by each of the of above mention combination must be connected to a high 5 volt and all the other data inputs must be connected to low ground. Okay, kita tengok. Okay, so okay, from here this one macam mana kita nak come out. Okay, macam mana kita nak come out this. This is tengok A bar, A2 bar, A1 bar, A0. So A2 bar, A1 bar, A0 is equal to 1. Okay, so this semua ni adalah yang yellow tadi. Okay, yang yellow. Okay, so macam mana kita nak connect. And then dia beritahu sini, dia mention, dia mention yang mana yang satu, all is connect to high volt, high, zero is connect to low ground. So A0, A1, 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 A2. Okay, kita refer dekat sini, kita tengok sini. Okay, kita refer sini nak mudah. Okay, kita letak sini kosong. Sorry, kita buat di sini sana. Okay, kosong, satu, dua, tiga. Okay, kosong, satu. Sini lah. This 0 0 0 is kosong, satu, dua, tiga, empat, lima, enam, tujuh. Okay, so kita tengok nombor apa yang kita letak dekat ground. Ground is 0 2 4 dengan 7. And then kita letak dekat VCC is 1 3 5 6. Okay, kita tengok di sini. Okay, so yang mana letak dekat ground adalah 0 2 4 7. Yang mana letak dekat VCC 1 3 5 6. Okay, yang ni, yang ini. Okay, so dua sini kita dapat. Okay, next. Design a logic circuit using mark. Okay. Okay, daripada sini. Okay, kita tengok. Sekarang kita ada, we have X, Y and Z. Okay, X, Y and Z. From here, kita ada 0000 0001 0010 0010 0001 0011 1001 1101 1101 1111. Okay, sini adalah based on kosong satu. Okay, tengok sini. This is two table. Okay. Okay, this is two table. Oh, ini tak ada kena mengena dengan atas. Circuit using mark ni. Okey, kita ini sebagai dia bagi contoh. Sekiranya F based on this. Okey, if F means 000 is 0, 001 is 1, 010 is 1, 011 is 0, 1000101 0, 1110 1111. Okay. Okay, from this, okay, kita hanya, we just have S0 and S1 only X, Y. Okay, so means X and Y, okay, we will refer sebagai selector lah. This is called selector. Okay, and then Z kita akan buat sebagai data. Okay, dalam this. Okay, how to get this? Okay, you see, kita tengok di sini 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, F 0 1. Okay, 0 1 mean F is equal Z. Okay. Okay. 0 1 is equal F is equal to Z. Okay, and then from here 0 1 0 0 1 1 means 1 0. Okay, 1 0 is F bar complement daripada sini. Okay, from here 0 1 is F, 1 0 is F bar, so means is equal to Z bar. Okay, and then 1 0 0 0 1, F is equal to 0 0, so that's why F is equal to, okay, that's why F is equal to 0. Okay, and then 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 is 1 1, that's why F is equal to 1. Okay, from that, from this, we'll get, okay, kita dapat based on this 0 1 2 3. Okay, from here macam mana dapat 0 1 2 3? This based on this X and Y. Okay, 0 0 0 0 is 0. Okay, 0 1 0 1 means 1. 10 means 2. 11 means 3. So we base on this, and then our result we refer from this. Okay? Refer from this. So means, okay, means if x x0 y0, z is selected, f is equal to z. Okay, if y1 x1 is equal to 3, so z is equal to 1. Okay, dia akan pilih nombor 3. Nombor 3 dia ada apa? Ada 1. Okey, 3 dia ada 1. Okey. This is a design logic circuit using mark. Okey, ini if 4 times 1 marks. Okey, kalau 8 times 1 marks. Okey, 8 times 1 marks. Kita akan, we need to refer from only this A, B, C. Sebab apa? Sebab kita nak refer dekat sini. Alamak. Okay, kita nak refer sini. Sini. Aduh. Sorry, gang. Okay, we want to refer this. Try tengok ini kotak. Ini untuk buat apa? We want to refer this sini, ni and sini. Sebab apa? Because the total ABC is 0. 0 0 0 0 0. So this is a 0. This one 0 0 1 0 1. So means sa 1. This one 2. This one 3. This one 4. This one 5. This one 6. And then this one is 7. Okay. Okay. From here. Okay. From here, we check first. From 0, f is equal to d, because you see f and d is same, 0 1 0 1. That's why f is equal to d. Okay, and then another one, f 0 1 0 1, f is equal to d. Next. Okay, next f 1 d 0. So mean f is equal to d d bar. Okay, f is equal to d bar, because this is 0 now. So f 1, so d is d bar. Next, f is 0 0 means f is 0, same 0 0, f is 0, F is 0, 1. Okay, 0, 1 means 0, 1 same means F is equal to D. And then F 1, 1, F is 1, 1, 1, 1, F is 1, 1. So this is our answer. Okay, this is our answer. Okay. 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 The question, how to get, okay, how to get this, macam mana dapat result ni? Okay, result ni based on question. Okay, based on question. Wait, okay, example for this question. Okay, okay, we refer this one first. Okay, how to get this. Okay, first apa yang saya cakap dulu, first problem kan. Okay, problem. Okay, problem dia di sini dia bagi F X Y Z is equal sum M. Okay, tengok sini apa, 1 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, yang mana yang satu dia bagi 1 2 6 7. Okay, bila soalan bagi macam ni, this is problem dia. Okay, this is a problem. Soalan macam ni dia bagi. And then from this, kita akan come out to table. Kita akan come out benda ni. So, bila dia bagi X, Y, Z means X, Y, Z is your input. And then your output if F. F dia dekat 1, 2, 6, 7. So, means 1, 2, 6 and 7. From this lah kita akan come out ni Z ni. Okay, come out this Z. Okay, saya tunjuk sekali lagi macam mana dapat dia. Okay, F is 0, 1. Okay, 0, 1 sama lah Z 0, 1. So, me F is equal to Z. And then F is equal to Z bar, because this 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. 1 ni berada di Z bar, berada kosong. So that's why F is equal to Z bar. Next, F is kosong kosong, F is equal to 0. And then next, F is 1, 1, F is equal to 1. So from this, kita akan come out benda ni. Okay, sama juga benda ni. Daripada sini kita akan dapat ABC is a selector. Okay, is a selector. And then D 0, 1 adalah this F. Okay, so means kalau F means kita tengok kat sini, kalau A kosong B 1 C kosong, tengok mana, tengok sini, kosong, satu kosong. So means dia akan pilih nombor 2. Dia akan ambil nombor 2, dia akan ambil D. D, nombor 2 ada apa? D bar. So here D bar. Okay, so kalau tak faham apa nanti, yang ni boleh PM saya. Okay, next, designing logic circuit using MUX. Okay, this is a decimal digit, so 0 until 15, so means A0 until A3, 000, 001, 2, 3, sampai 15. And then output Y ni output yang diberi yang untuk kita keluarkan dia. Okay, so sini dia tak tunjuk. Okay, so buat sama macam tadi juga. Okay, kita ambil A3, A2, A1. Okay, A3, A2, A1 as a selector, and then A0 sebagai kita punya data input. Okay, sama juga macam ni. Okay, and then cascading mark. Okay, cascading marks using 3-2-1 marks to make 4-1 mark. Okay, cascade ni maksud kita guna, contoh ni kita guna 2-1 marks untuk kita jadikan 4-1 marks. Okay, untuk dapat 4-1 mark kita menggunakan 3-2 marks. Sebab 4-2-1 bermaksud kita ada berapa selector. 4-2-1 kita ada 2 selector. So from here 2-2-1 kita ada 1 selector. Okay, 4-2-1 kita ada 2 selector, 1 selector. Okay, okay, how to design this? Okay, 4 selector means kita ada 2, kita ada 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then kita ada 1 output F. Okay, so from this state here S1, S0, okay, S1, 1, S0, 1, okay, 0, 0, F is equal I0, 0, 1 is I1, 1, 0 is I2, 1, 1 is I3, okay, so bermaksud connection dia S0, macam ni S0 S1. So kita akan dapat sini S0 S1, ini I0 I1 I2 I3. Okay, so dapat 4 times 1 marks. Okay, so kita dapat this one 4 input. Okay, this one sambung ke 2. Sini S sorry, sini I0, sini I1. Okay, okay, yang ni pula 8-to-1 multiplexer using 2-to-1 multiplexer. Kita nak buat 8-to-1 multiplexer and then 2-to-1 multiplexer. Dia menggunakan 2-to-1 multiplexer. So 8-to-1 kita menggunakan berapa? 8 kita ingat means 2 kali 2 kali 2 sama dengan 8. So kita ada S0, S1, S2 means 2 power of 3. This is 3 ni adalah N. Okay, so sama dengan 8. So kita mean kita menggunakan T 3, 1, 2, T 3. So kita gunakan 3, kita start from sama macam tadi 1, 2, 4. Okay, sambung S naught. S naught sini. And then S1. And then S2. Okay, so sambung macam tadi. So kita akan dapat this using 2-to-1 multiplexer untuk buat 8-to-1 multiplexer. Okay, this is a multiplexer. Okay, so saya stop. Saya sambung next. Okay, saya sambung di multiplexer.